I'm going to show you how you can pre-fill Airtable forms with existing records. I'll be using this tool by miniextensions.com, and I will add a URL to this in the description. So the idea here is, let's say you have a customer, and this customer, every time they visit you to check in, they fill in a form. So in my case, I want the customer to, submit a request, and I want to attach to that request their phone number, email, and address. Now, this customer that's coming has already has an existing records and record in my table. So what I want to do is I want to take the values from the existing record and pre-fill that Airtable form. So in my case, let's try to grab John here and paste John in the search, hit search. So what we're doing here is we're grabbing that record and then pre-filling the form. And then John can, instead of, inputting his email, phone number, and address every time, they just get pre-filled. And he can submit his new request however he wants. And he gets, to hit submit, comes back here, and then the record is added. So now there are two records for John, and the newest record has that new request. And the idea here is that, these are obviously duplicated records, but you can, deduplicate them however you want, etc. So now let's try to do the same flow, but for a user that does not already exist. So if a user does not already exist in the table, so let's just do hit submit. So because this is an email that I just made up, it doesn't exist in the table, the email gets filled, and then the user would have to add their phone number, address, and request. So that's pretty much how it works. Now I'm going to show you how you can set this up. So if you buy the extension, this is what you would see on the right here. I'm going to put them side by side so we can toggle between them. So you would start by filling up your API key, base ID, and table ID. Follow the blue URLs to find those. Next, we want the lookup fields. So when you saw me earlier, I had only one text field, right? Like the user only confirms one text field, which was the email. Now, if you need multiple fields, if you want to confirm, let's say, the email and phone, so you do some cross confirming so that the user is definitely that person, you can add multiple field names here. In my case, I'm just going to keep doing email. So I'm going to grab this email, make sure that's case sensitive. I'm going to drop it in here. Next, I'm going to look for that form URL and then add that form URL to the extension. I'm going to grab that, drop it in here. Now, next is the fields and form. So the idea here is these are the fields that will show up in the form. What we want is the fields that we want to pre-fill only. So this is not just the fields that are in the form, but the fields in the form that you would like to pre-fill. So in my case, for example, it really wouldn't make sense to pre-fill a request, right? Because I want the user to add a new request every time. But I do want to pre-fill the email, the phone, and the address. So what I would do is I would remove that request from here. And then only the email, phone, and address would get pre-filled. And then request would always start blank. If you have any percent type fields or duration type fields, make sure you add them here. Let's go ahead and save. So let's go ahead and test this real quick. We click on the share URL, go over here, let me grab that email again, and hit search. It should get pre-filled. There you go.